I did. Yeah, I did. Checked her notifications. What, do you like milk? Do you like milk? Nice. I just did.
Anything you want to share? Very well. Mr. Williams, these charges against you are not minor crimes. Federal statute requires a
25 year minimum sentence. But we're already going
into a game. Please, Your Honor, I'm telling you, I didn't do it. You've already been found guilty. So unless the people have anything else. This court hereby sentences the defendant Robert Williams to 25 years in a federal prison without the possibility of parole.
Oh, God. Watching Doorman. Go on team orange.
Wait. Excuse me. Hey, I'm sorry, Your Honor. He didn't do it. May I approach you? Ma'am. Your Honor, there is no way that Mr. Williams committed those crimes. You see, we have here a fraud statement. Purchases made by the defendant with his credit card on the same day that the crime took place in the jail. And I also have a photo of the defendant in the store here in Los Angeles during the hot dog, just a mere moment before the crime took place. And I have a video as well, Your Honor, that shows the defendant at Dodger Stadium at the exact time and date the crime was taking place.
So you see, Your Honor, Robert Williams did not commit those crimes. He's telling the truth all along. Is all this true, Mr. Griffin? Well, why don't you see? Because.
Yeah.
More
Soon try to punch your feet.
I presented him with all of his evidence, Your Honor. Yet, well, what'd you expect?
It's you, because you scored one.
Okay, so...
And now you scored two.
Didn't do this crime. But
I'm gonna score more goals than you.
Look at him, he's clearly a criminal, Your Honor.
I know.
I've heard all I can.
Yeah! I got it from the item shop.
And you, Mr. Grant, obstructing justice and tampering with evidence is a very serious crime.
Your Honor,
I'm going to see to it that not only do you never practice law, but that we send the right man to jail this time. You, Bailey, arrest him.
For us, the one part's crucial.
What? Did you see that powerball right there?
Thank you.
No, I have more.
No problem, but do something.
What?
Still in it seriously.
No, it's me.
Oh, no, it's
me. No, it's me.
Hey, it's no problem. You have a nice day.
Okay. Thanks. So, you were saying? Sorry. Just the way that's...
Can I have a 1v1? No, it's not a challenge. We're on the same team, so we're gonna win.
My skin tone isn't one of the reasons my life is hard. I've seen it firsthand.
You have?
You see those two kids over there? Those are both my boys. Gregory's my biological son, and Anthony is my husband's from his first marriage. And even though those boys have grown up in the same house, they've had completely different life experiences. You see, when my son Greg walks through our neighborhood, nobody minds. All of the neighbors say hello to him. But when my son Anthony walks through our neighborhood, people cross the street when they see him, clutching their purses as if he was a threat. And when my son Greg goes to a store, he's able to shop freely without having to worry about anyone thinking that he's suspicious. But when my son Anthony goes into a store, he gets looked at as if he's going to steal something. It's treated like a criminal. So you see, as the mom of boys with two different skin tones, I've seen firsthand that people do really get treated differently based on the color of their skin.
Wow. To be honest, that's something I've never experienced before. Maybe if I saw with my own eyes, I'd understand it better.
Mom, help!
Oh my God, Anthony! Officer, what's going on?
Ma'am, do you know this boy?
Yes, he's my son.
Look at that goal. I'm clipping this.